Hi, it's Mr. Anderson, and this is AP Environmental Sciences, Video 31. It's on solid waste. Generally, in the natural world, waste is not wasted. These two dung beetles are fighting over this ball of elephant dung as a food resource, and through most of humans' history, we really haven't produced that much solid waste. This changed post-industrialization, especially after World War II, we started to live in a throwaway society, where we produce waste that we don't reuse, recycle, or fix when it's broken. And so we're filling up landfills with waste that the natural world doesn't want. These seagulls might eat some of the food, but the rest of it will lay in this landfill for thousands of years into the future. And so MSW, or municipal solid waste, you should understand what are the major types of waste. It's generally going to be paper, plastics, wood, yard clipping, metal, things like that. There are a couple of types that you should be familiar with. E-waste, that's going to be our computers, phones, and televisions as we throw those away. And then hazardous waste. This is going to be waste that causes an impact in human illness or changes that degrade the environment. And we have regulations in place. The two ones you should be familiar with are RCRA, the Resource Conservation and Recovery Act, and then CERCLA, otherwise known as Superfund Act. And that's a way to clean up huge areas of hazardous waste. That solid waste is eventually disposed of either in a landfill or incinerated. But the key point is, how do we reduce the amount of solid waste? How do we minimize that? The one you're probably familiar with is the idea of the three R's. We should reduce it, reuse it, recycle it, and a type of that is going to be composting. And so municipal solid waste, if we look over the last half century in the US, it's been increasing from 88 million tons of MSW in 1960 to around 251 today. So you can see it's increasing over time, and it's starting to level off as we start to recycle more of that. And this is per capita, per person, how much waste we're producing. You should be familiar with what most of that waste is. This is from the EPA. It's generally going to be paper, food, yard trimmings, plastics, rubber, metals. 251 million tons per year. If we look at how much is actually disposed of, it's around 65% of that. This is to scale. And the reason why is that we're recycling a lot of it. We're recycling especially the paper, the yard trimmings, and the metal, composting a lot of those yard trimmings. E-waste is a type of this waste. It's going to be the electronics. We put some of this in landfills. Unfortunately, a lot of it moves to developing countries where they recycle the parts of it. And there aren't standards, health standards in place, so it's really dangerous. And then we have hazardous waste. So chemicals that have been produced, oven cleaner, for example, in your house would be an example of a hazardous waste. And so we don't just bury that because it gets into the ground supply. And so we've got regulations that make sure that we're storing it properly. And that legislation could be broken down into RCRA and CERCLA. RCRA is going to be the Resource Conservation and Recovery Act, and then the Superfund Act. If we look at RCRA, that's going to regulate hazardous materials from cradle to grave, from the point it's created to when it's eventually stored. The way that works is we leverage taxes on the industries that produce these hazardous wastes, and we can use that to help store them. And so, for example, that oven cleaner in your house that you bought for $5 is hazardous waste. And so when you're done with it, if you don't use it, it's going to go to a place in your city where they can control that as a hazardous waste. The Superfund Act started with a very famous contamination. It's called Love Canal. This is in Niagara Falls, New York. And so back in the 40s and 50s, a chemical company had been dumping hazardous waste and simply covering it. And that eventually, that land was sold off to a school, houses were built on top of it, we started to get birth defects, miscarriages, huge increases in illness, and they finally could trace it back to this. And so what the Superfund Act does is look at areas where we have huge contamination due to hazardous waste. All the red ones on here are Superfund sites, the green ones are ones that are done, and the yellow ones are proposed Superfund sites. And so what we're doing is cleaning up the hazard waste and holding those responsible if they're still around, those people who caused the contamination. And so how do we minimize the amount of waste? We don't want to dispose of it. And so we can think of it like this, from the least favored to the most favored. So we can dispose of it, or we can get some of the energy from it. But we want to recycle it if we can. We want to then reuse it if we can and reduce it in the first place. So if we kind of break through those top three in recycling, as this material goes to the landfill, we have people that can remove some of that recycling stuff that we can use again. Now, that's pretty energy intensive, and so if we can have us do the sorting before it actually gets there, that's helpful. We have what's called closed loop recycling. That's where we take something like aluminum cans and we recycle that back to make more aluminum cans. And then we have open loop recycling. And that's when we take something like plastic bottles and we can use that to make more plastic bottles, or we can use it to make something like a polar fleece jacket. We also want to recycle nutrients. So composting in your backyard is a way to reduce the amount that goes to the landfill, and even at a large industrial scale. What we want to do is take those nutrients and put them back into the environment. We can reuse things. So this is a giant coil that was, we had electrical coil that was wrapped around it, and it's now used as a table. So if we can use things again, if you can give it to somebody else, give it to Goodwill, you can sell it through eBay or Craigslist, then we can reuse this material. And at the best, we want to not even make it to begin with. And so if you have a bag that you take to the supermarket, then you don't have to choose, do I want plastic or do I want paper? You're not using either of those. And we can do it on an industrial level as well. So Subaru, for example, is one of the first companies to go to a zero landfill policy. They're not putting anything in landfills. How do they do that? They're recycling, they're reusing materials, and the little bit that's actually produced at the end, they're incinerating that to produce energy. And so this is what one of these plants looks like. We can burn that garbage or that unused garbage to produce a little bit of energy instead of not using it at all. And so if it eventually moves to the point where we have to dispose of it, we have to make a landfill properly. How do you do that? You dig a big hole, and then we're going to line it with plastic, or better yet, clay. Clay is not going to allow material to leach out, and then it's also going to grab a lot of those metals just due to its charge. We then put a leachate system in it, so it's a bunch of pipes, and so any water that leaks out is going to be recovered. Sometimes it's recycled back again. We then fill it up with garbage, and then we're going to cover it with soil. We want to make sure that we compact it the whole way so we don't have a lot of decomposition going on in there. We don't want a lot of water to move down there. We'll also build pipes in there because methane gas is going to be produced, and we want to get rid of that as well. And so did you learn the following? Do you know what solid waste is? The worst type is going to be hazardous waste. We've got RCRA and the Superfund Act to kind of regulate that. We want to minimize it. We can reduce it. We can reuse it, recycle it, and compost it. And then if we have to, we can incinerate it. That's called waste to energy system. And then a last kind of ditch effort is to put it in a landfill, but we want to make sure that we construct it properly. So that's solid waste, and I hope that was helpful.